So dear friends, the topic for today is setting arrangements. This is from the logical reasoning part. Setting arrangements in a orderly manner, not random. Setting arrangements can be of two types. It can be linear or it can be circular. So we'll discuss two types of setting arrangements, linear and circular type. Linear means in a line. Like when you sit in a classroom, in a line, from left to right. So linear arrangement means where all the persons are sitting in a line. Suppose these are the five persons, A, B, C, D, E. They are sitting in a line from left to right. So first we have to mark the corners or the ends. So this is the left corner or left end. This is the right corner or the right end. So we can say A is sitting at the left corner and E is sitting at the right corner and C is sitting at exactly at the center of the line. Now suppose somebody asks who is sitting third to the right of A. So we will proceed from A and see the third position. First, second, third. So third to the right of A. Who is sitting? D. Who is sitting second to the left of E? So start from E. Go towards left direction. First, second. So we reach to C. C is sitting second to the left of E. So this may be the position left and right question based on this. Then somebody may ask who is the neighbor of B. Neighbor means adjacent. We have to see both in left and right. So neighbors of B are A and C. Neighbors of C are B and D. Neighbors of D are C and E. But who is sitting, who is a neighbor of E? Because E is sitting at the right corner. So there is nobody to the right of E. Only to the left of E. D is the neighbor of E. Similarly, only B is the neighbor of A. So neighbor or adjacent persons. So linear arrangements, first we have to mark the corners, start from the corner, left corner or right corner, then arrange the persons accordingly. Second type, which I told you, circular. Sitting in a circle. Like some if we are sitting for dinner around a round table, so that is circular arrangement. Or for group discussions, we sit around a table, so that is circular arrangement. In circular, you can see there is no end or no corner. Circle doesn't have any corner or end. So that is an important point. So let us make a circle. This is the center of the circle. So suppose A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H. So these 8 persons are sitting around a circle. The arrow is showing their faces. That means they are sitting opposite to each other, facing each other, face to face. Means the face of A is towards E. And face of E is towards A. And everybody is facing towards the center. That is the important point. Everybody should face towards the center O. And they have to sit symmetrically, means with equal spacing. So they have to be arranged at equal spacing and face to face. Now we can see who is sitting opposite to each other. Opposite means diagonally opposite. So you can see who is sitting opposite to each other. Who is sitting opposite of A? E. So A is sitting opposite of E. Who is sitting opposite of B? So you can see F. B and F are opposite. Similarly, C and G are opposite. D and H are opposite to each other. So this is the meaning of opposite. Now somebody asks, who is sitting right of A? Who is sitting to the right of A? That is not B, it is H. Because you have to imagine, you are sitting in the place of A and you are facing towards the center. So this will be your right side and this will be your left side. So opposite of A will be H and right of A will be H and left of A will be B. Now for E, what will be position? So E is sitting with his face towards center O. So right of E will be D and left of E will be F. So right and left depends on the person. It will change from person to person. So what you have to do? Imagine that you are sitting in the place of that person with your face held towards the center. Then your right and left will be the same as the right of and left of that person. So accordingly you can mark right and left. Another concept in this can be the direction. Who is sitting second to the clockwise of A? So clockwise means this direction. This is clockwise. So start from A, first is B, second is C. So C is sitting second to the clockwise of A. And who is sitting third to the anti-clockwise of A? So this is the anti-clockwise direction, opposite of clock, anti-clockwise. So start from A, H, G, F. So third to the anti-clockwise of A will be F. So here both are important, right and left, or clockwise or anti-clockwise. Now as I have told you that there is no end or corner of a circle. So how we'll start making this diagram and how we'll start the circular setting arrangement. So we should have a starting point. So generally the top position A, this is the position fixed, top of the circle. So generally we start from A, out of the top vertical position. So first fix the position at the top vertical, A in this case, and then accordingly arrange other persons as per the information given in the question. So let us take some examples to understand this arrangement, circular and linear. So I will take the questions from the book practice set. You can also see the questions. So these are the three questions based on circular arrangement. So first read the directions carefully, because in the directions it will be clear how we have to make the diagram. Diagram is very important. So the questions from 1 to 3 are based on the information given below. Four ladies A, B, C, D. So these are the four ladies A, B, C, D. And four gentlemen E, F, G, H. So total we have 8 persons, 4 ladies and 4 gentlemen. Ladies are A, B, C, D and gentlemen are E, F, G, H. They are sitting in a circle around a table facing each other. No two ladies or two gentlemen are sitting side by side. What does that mean? That means they are sitting alternately. The ladies and the gents are sitting alternately. No two ladies or two gentlemen are sitting side by side. Now proceeding further, what is the information given? First, C is sitting between G and E, facing D. So first I will list out the information given below. C, now who is a lady, is sitting between G and E, and C is facing D, means C and D are opposite to each other. Second information given to you, F is between D and A, facing G. F is sitting between D and A and is facing G. Means F and G are opposite to each other. Third information given in the question is H is right of B. H is sitting right of B. So these are the information given to you, 1, 2 and 3. Based on this, now we have to make a proper diagram, proper circle. So first make a circle like this, mark the center and mark 8 positions symmetrically like this. Now question is where to start. So I told you the top position should be the starting point. So I will start from here. I will sit C here, because first sentence C is sitting between G and E is facing D. So C is facing D. So C and D position are fixed. Now C is between G and E. So provisionally I will sit G and D like this. We can interchange also further if it is not matching to the information given. So C is between G and E is facing D. Second statement says F is between D and A and facing G. So facing G, F should be here. And F is between D and A. So now the position of A is also fixed like this. So now you see G, C, E, A, F, T. 6 persons are already seated. Now is left only H and B. Now, as already informed in the question, ladies and gents are sitting alternate. So G and H are both are gents. So H cannot sit adjacent to G. So H can sit here. And only position left for B is now this. So now this completes our diagram. As you can see again, now you can verify the informations. C is between G and E facing D. Second statement, F is between D and A facing G. Third statement, H is right of B. Right of B. H is sitting. So all the statements are satisfied. That means this is the correct diagram which we have drawn. So main thing in this is drawing the correct diagram. That will take the time. Now based on this we can answer the questions. First question, who is sitting left of A? Left of A. Options are E, F, G and H. So you now can see left of A. So A is sitting like this. So this is right of A, this is left of A. Who is sitting left of A? It is F. So first question number one answer is B option A. F is sitting left of A. Second question is E is facing whom? Who is opposite of E? So now we can see opposite of E diagonally. It is H. The second question again, option number B is correct. H is sitting opposite of E, or E is facing H. Third question, Who are the immediate neighbors of B? Means left and right of B. So we can say G and H are the neighbors of B. So this is the first option, A option. Who are the immediate neighbors of B? G and H. So in a circle, everybody will have two neighbors because left and right. So this completes our set of circular arrangement. So I hope the diagram is clear and the answers are clear. Because once you make the correct diagram, then you can solve all the questions immediately. The main time taking thing will be the diagram. Diagram should be correct and satisfying all the information given. Now we'll take up one set of questions based on linear arrangement. Question number 4 to 6. In a car exhibition, 7 different companies, Cadillac, Ambassador, Fiat, Maruti, Mercedes, Bedford and Fargo. These are the brands of cars, different companies, their brand names. They are displayed in a row facing east such that now the informations are given. So here we have to make a line. Straight line. Mark the corners left and right. Mark the position. And I can mark the position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There were 7 cars. So I mark the position 1 to 7. And the corners are marked left to right. Now based on the information, now we have to arrange the cars at the correct positions. So first is Cadillac car was the immediate right of Fargo. Fargo was 4 to the right of Fiat. But this is not giving information about the corner on the end. Second, Maruti car was between Ambassador car and Bedford. From this also we cannot make out the corner position. Third statement, Fiat, which was third to the left of Ambassador car, was at one of the end. So this is useful. Now we know Fiat is at one of the end. But which end? Left end or right end? So again, read the statement, Fiat was third to the left of Ambassador car. That means Fiat cannot be at the right end. Fiat has to be at the left end, means number 1. So this is Fiat. At the left corner, or the left end, Fiat is there. And it is third to the left of Ambassador. Means Ambassador will be at what position? 1 plus 3, 4. So Ambassador is at the fourth position. So now we have fixed two cars, Fiat and Ambassador. Fiat at 1 and Ambassador at 4. Maruti car was between Ambassador car and Bedford. So I can place Maruti car between Ambassador and Bedford. So this is Maruti, I am writing MR, Bedford, BDF. So number 1 Fiat, number 2 Bedford, number 3 Maruti, number 4 Ambassador. Cadillac car was immediate right of Fargo. And Fargo was 4 to the right of Fiat. means Fargo will be 1 plus 4, 5, fifth position. So this is Fargo, and Cardillac immediate right of Fargo. The immediate right of Fargo means at number, Fargo is at number 5, so right of Fargo number 6. Which car? Cardillac CD. So now again you can see the 6 cars have been arranged. Left corner number 1 is Fiat, number 2 Bedford, number 3 Maruti, number 4 Ambassador, number 5 Fargo, number 6 Cardillac. Now which car is left? You can see now only Mercedes is left. And which position is left? Only number 7 position is left now. So Mercedes has to be at number 7. Mercedes MD. So now again you can see the diagram has been completed. For your convenience again I will write number 1 is Fiat, number 2 the car is Bedford, number 3 it is Maruti, number 4 it is Ambassador, number 5 Fargo, number 6 Cardillac, and number 7 is the Mercedes. So this completes our diagram for the linear arrangement. So now we can mark the answers. Fourth question. Which of the following cars are correct position of Mercedes? Mercedes at number 7. So we can make out the correct option as C, because Maruti is at third position. 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. So Mercedes is 4 to the right of Maruti. So answer is option C for the fourth question. Fifth question, which car is on the immediate either sides of Cadillac car? Cadillac left and right are, we can see from the diagram, so none of the options are matching. So answer is E, none of this. Because Cadillac is between Fargo and Mercedes, so none of the options are matching. Question number 6. Which of the group of car is right of ambassador car? Right of ambassador. So ambassador is at fourth position. So right of ambassador. Are Mercedes, Cadillac and Fargo. So this is option. C. So fourth answer is D. Mercedes is 4 to the right of Maruti. Fifth, none of this because no option is matching, option E. And sixth, C. Right of ambassador there are Fargo, Cadillac and Mercedes. So this completes the set of questions based on linear arrangement. So now if it is clear, the diagram is very important. First make the correct diagram, then solve the questions. So again I will tell you the correct answer. Fourth, D option. Fifth, E option. And sixth, C option.